Welcome to your Daily Dose of Dani. I am Dani Rocco, and a sign of change. Well, first off, got me some Black Rifle coffee. Check it out, super cool company. Gotta put your money in what you believe in. Put your money in what you don't believe in, you're not gonna get a lot of prosperity. Put your money in your heart, what you do believe in, and it'll like come to you like fire. Amazing things. But here's a sign of change. I talk about having a mission statement as a couple, as an individual, in every aspect of your life, right? Because if you don't, how are you gonna know when you're pissed off or when times are bad, where you're going? So here's a sign of change and how a sign of implementing your mission statement. So I was in a situation where, how do I say this? I gotta think how I'm gonna say this. Okay, where a mission statement was made in a part of my life. And then it was made to make that part of my life better, right? So apply this to yourself. You create a mission statement in part of your life to make that part of your life better. Now, we're not perfect humans, so we frig up, right? And a frig up situation happened, and the emotional patterns went backwards in time to the place before that mission statement was made. But here's the thing, and here's the sign of change. One, you can sit back there in that and just be like, well, this is it, and this is how I want to feel, and I have the right to feel that way, which is your ego. Or you could take a minute and be like, I don't like this feeling. And that's what I did. I do not like this feeling. And it was so hard for me to articulate what the feeling was and then speak it to that person. Because then speaking it to that person actually is creating the change, which is going to keep you moving towards the mission statement. You can't keep it here. But the part that makes it so hard to talk to that other person or even to yourself is your ego, right? You get fearful, you get righteous. You're like, righteous, I think, is the best word to put it. You're like, I have the right to feel this way, and you made me this way, and blah, blah, blah. All ego. So once you talk to them, and you talk to them from a neutral standpoint, them or yourself, and you take your emotion out of it, you decide you're not going to feel the way you want your feeling at this moment. You put yourself, your state of mind, in the place where you want to feel, man, your communication is so much better. And guess what? You start moving towards that mission statement because you took your ego and your emotion out of it. And then change happens. So the next time that situation comes up, you're going to, oh, that wasn't a good snap. That wasn't a good snap either. Forget the snap. You're going to be that much closer of quickly moving through those old habits, into those other habits, into the new habits, into that forward movement of where you want to go. So creating change means you're going to go backwards a little bit, but how quickly you move out of that, there it is, out of that backward spot shows the progress that you're having, shows the change that you're having in your life. So have an awesome, amazing, fantastic, God-loving Sunday. Stay true to who you are. Do not let your fears overcome you. And if you're feeling anything that is not bringing you love, that is your ego working. And you got to fight against that. And I will see you on the other side. Ooh! Hey, so if you're going to be in Spokane, awesome. Grab your ticket for the 3-day event. It's like fun. I can't even describe how you walk away. You do not need to be a veteran. You do not need to be a first responder. You do not need to be a family member of any of those to come and enjoy and get stuff out of it. There's going to be dancing and hopefully not singing from me, but singing from great people. Interviews for the documentary that goes right along with Devoted to the Soldier book. We're going to be talking about the book. You're going to see amazing people. Dick Liberty is now coming around. If you don't know him, check out his page, Dick Liberty. He has a podcast. Love him. He is a Marine veteran who just says it like it is. So I cannot wait to work with him out there. He's going to be moderating it and then going live. We're going to be having a potluck, fun, dance with live band, big stuff. But if you can't make it, we will come to you. Although, We have this huge list that's happening. Collecting all these stories from these heroes are so fuels my fire, and I cry a lot. Yes, I do cry a lot when it happens. But I think there's going to be a way to watch it live or listen to it live through now that Dick Liberty has his podcast there. So that will be super duper duper cool. And I will see you on the other side.